Brandon Rios has been training his ass off. Him and Victor Ortiz are in a collision course for February 2017. Break down the fight, Rios-Ortiz.
What a great fight, just in terms of the history and the energy and the fire that you get from these guys in that fight.
Both of them know you and like you.
And I like them.
They're funny.
Yeah. Oh, they're very entertaining. They're entertaining out of the ring. They're entertaining in the ring. I love those guys. Break down the fight. You know, if they fought now, it would be like, I think, even when they were in their primes. I'm not suggesting they're way past it, but they're probably not as good as they once were. I think maybe Victor's a little bit too athletic for Brandon. If he doesn't want to engage him, I think he might be too quick, too athletic for him. But Brandon has a way of just staying on top of you and pounding and making you fight. So that could turn out to be an amazing fight, especially when you factor in the history that the two have with each other. I'd like to see that fight.
I'm leaning towards Brandon, of course. He has the bigger heart. He's been more consistent. Victor, we don't know as of late where he is, but it's going to be a great promotion. Will we see them on the cover of Ring Magazine if the fight goes down?
Probably not. But
don't count on it.
But don't rule anything out.
Okay, one last thing I'm going to ask you about. Lomachenko-Walters is a fight I think some people are sleeping on, but it's a huge fight. What do you think about
it? I love Lomachenko-Walters. But I want to qualify that, though. I want the Walters who beat Donaire to show up against Lomachenko. If that Walters shows up to fight Lomachenko, we could see one hell of a fight. Now, I don't see anybody beating Lomachenko. I just think he's the complete fighter at this point. Let's put it this way, I'd be shocked if Walters won this fight. But Walters is potentially a beast. So, I mean, that's just a really, really good matchup just from an entertainment standpoint. So I'm really, really looking forward to that fight. So it's kind of cool. We have Ward Kovalev Saturday. Then next week we have Walters and Lomachenko. Two really good back-to-back matchups.
And my last question, Michael Rosenthal, Ring Magazine. What is next for Canelo, if you were a betting man? Canelo Alvarez, he just beat Liam Smith. His hand is healing.
I don't know who... Let's assume that he fights in May and then again in September. I don't know who he fights in May. There's a number of possibilities, but I think he's going to fight Golovkin in September.
Wow.
So I think that it's been built up now and built up. I think the time is right. I think he'll be more comfortable at middleweight at that point. I just think the time is right. He'll make a ton of money. If he wins, he's beyond a superstar. If he loses, it's okay because he's losing to a guy who's perceived as a great fighter. So I just think it's a win-win both ways. So, and I think it's happening in December.
All right, Mike, tell people where to follow you on Twitter.
Follow us at, oh boy, you know what? I'm not even sure. Oh, at Ring Magazine.
All right, there you have it. Thank you so much. Mike Rosenthal, make sure to pick up your Ring Magazine. Who's on the cover next month?
Bernard Hopkins.
All right, making history December 17th in L.A.
Yeah.
FacingReport.com, Willie Spike reporting.